Writing your first SwiftUI app is one of the easiest things you can do, but it's also one of the hardest things to get right. So in this video, I have compiled 4 years of working with SwiftUI into the 10 commandments of SwiftUI. I have condensed my experience into these actionable insights so you don't have to go through the trial and error I needed to go through. If you're brand new to SwiftUI development, or even if you've been doing this for years, you will surely benefit from these evergreen principles. So let's get into the 10 commandments of SwiftUI. The first commandment is, you shall have one source of truth. And this is so true about SwiftUI. You want to have only one source of truth. If you have multiple sources of truth, you will have like this spaghetti code. You will not know where the data lies. You will have views not updating properly because you have multiple sources of truth. Basically, wherever you instantiate an observable object with a state object, you know that that is your source of truth. Now, number two, data shall drive the UI. This is the second commandment of SwiftUI, that data is driving everything in SwiftUI, including the UI. So whenever you are building out SwiftUI apps, you want to think of it as a data management perspective. So data goes through stages, of course, through time, and the UI will automatically update itself according to those data changes. Yeah, it's really, really important to grasp this. It's the quite opposite of what we have in UIKit, but this is really, really super fun. If you adhere to the first principle that you shall have only one source of truth for one particular object, then this second one, data shall drive the UI, is quite easy to follow up on. Oh, hey, sorry to interrupt. Before we get into the next commandment, I want to take a step back and invite you into SwiftUI Nation, my private community. SwiftUI Nation, as the name implies, is a community for SwiftUI developers. Members have access to me 24/7 through the SwiftUI Nation Discord server and get weekly one-hour group coaching where you can ask me anything. On top of that, you'll get access to the members-only SwiftUI Helper framework that helped me build SwiftUI apps for my clients 10 times faster and easier. Boost your SwiftUI knowledge, join SwiftUI Nation today, link is down in the description. Commandment number three is, you shall construct your views as a recipe. Now in UIKit, we are adding in UI views, UI buttons, UI text field, UI collection views, and all of those are kind of objects that you kind of see that they are already on the screen. Now in SwiftUI, it's quite the opposite. You are not adding a button, you are not adding a scroll view, you are not adding a text. You are simply creating a recipe source for SwiftUI to kind of know where to put your views, what to do with them according to your data changes. It is only a recipe. That's why it's called a struct and we are not using classes. Okay, commandment number four, honor the four types of views. Now, what are the four types of views? Actually, if you know the first two, then you will know the last two. The first one is the pull-in view. Now, pull-in views are those views that are going to try to pull every other view around themselves to themselves. And that is the pull-in view. Now, the push-out view, that's the second type of view, is quite the opposite. They are trying to stretch themselves as much as possible to take up as much possible as space as they can. Now, the third one, that's kind of an outlier. It's the image, not the system named image. It's just the simple image. And that is one that you add in your assets and you just call image and you just add in the name of your image. Now, for that, you want to make it resizable and you also want to add a frame to it. Now, the frames are the devil. I'm going to talk about that in an upcoming commandment. But let's go on to the type of view that we just have kind of mix and match with, and that is the divider. Now, if you put the divider into a horizontal stack, it will be a pull-in view in this way and a push-out view on the other way, or axis, I mean, and if you put them onto a vertical stack, then it will be the other way around. So it's kind of a pull-in view and a push-out view at the same time, but according to the container that you are adding to into it, it will behave differently. Okay, commandment number 5, you shall avoid frame. Now, why is that? Because we talked about the image previously and you needed to add a frame to it because you add it as a resizable. So yeah, you want to add a frame to it. But what about other views? Now, you should avoid frame as the plague in a SwiftUI application. You want your recipe to be without a frame so SwiftUI can lay out your views accordingly, like in a manner, like really, really stylishly, I would say. Because if you add a frame to it, like a constant width and height or either of those, then you will have some surprises. So avoid the frame as much as possible. Commandment number 6, remember to encapsulate your view models. Yes. MVVM works really, really fine with SwiftUI, but you have to remember what the view model actually means. It's a view model for your view. So what you want to do is not let it loose, so to speak. You want this to be constrained for your view only. What this means in coding terms is that you actually want it to be a private extension on your file that contains your view. I have previous videos on that, so go ahead and check them out. Number 7, you shall not abuse the environment object. And it kind of comes from the previous one. Like, of course, you want to create your environment object so you have different published variables available on multiple views, so you don't have to inject them into your views over and over again down the, let's say, navigation chain. So you are creating an environment object, but you have to be really careful because now that published variable will be available in all of your views all the time. So yeah, you gotta be really, really specific on what views you are going to access your environment object. Commandment number 8, you shall refactor large views. Now this is a no-brainer, and also Apple recommends this. If your view is, let's say, longer than around 100 lines, then most probably you have a good chance to refactor your view. Make sure that you subtract and refactor, of course, your subviews or some parts of your view, like in terms of functionality. Make sure that you do not have large views. It's a pain to read and you will thank me later after 2 months. Commandment number 9, you shall avoid stringly typed code. Now, SwiftUI uses some stringly typed code. So for example, for the image named, so you are going to type in the name of the image as a string, or also for the system named images, you know, the SF symbols, you are going to type out a string. Now, that is really, really dangerous in my eye. So what you want to do and just simply create an enum for all of those strings. Just type it in once, make sure that you type it correctly, and then you can just use it everywhere. And finally, commandment number 10, you shall never say that SwiftUI is not production ready. Now, this is kind of obvious. Everybody's talking about how production ready SwiftUI is. Believe me, it is. But that's just my opinion. So what you want to do is just build apps with SwiftUI. Go ahead, take it for a spin, try it out. And if it is production ready for your type of app, then it is. And if it's not, then of course you can just go and deep down for UIKit. And of course, SwiftUI goes really, really well with the preview provider, so you can just work really fast. But I highly recommend that you take a look at hot reloading your simulator. The video is right over here.